Hey everybody, this is Nick. I'm so excited to share with you the best, the freest PowerPoint add-in that you are going to want to run to, especially if you're like me and you use PowerPoint for other things like social media graphics. This is my file of thumbnails for YouTube, my YouTube thumbnails right here. I have tons, I have hundreds of YouTube thumbnails right here that I've designed in PowerPoint. And you know, I don't do a lot of resizing into other social media formats, quite frankly, because I just don't have the time and it seems annoying. I know that we know how to update custom slide sizes in PowerPoint, right? You go up to the design tab on the ribbon, and then you go over here under the customize menu, that slide size, and then you can click on slide size right there. And then you get the drop down of all the different sizes that you could do, some kind of canned sizes that PowerPoint has for you. But these are really, these are not necessary for us for the most part. But you have like a banner and an overhead and a widescreen. You have a letter size that we use quite often. It says 8.5 by 11, but it's actually 7.5 by 10. You still have to customize that when you do it. But there's nothing for social media. So the amazing people at Bright Carbon, Jamie Garrock specifically, he's a PowerPoint MVP, and he has, I'm gonna put this link above and below, so make sure to go to this site. You can see all the documentation. He has really, almost overnight it seemed, created this really cool add-in that anybody can download for free, even if you are on a corporate PowerPoint version. You don't need admin access to download this add-in. So I urge you to go and do it. It's so cool. It's so free. Just scroll down to this website on their site right here. Scroll all the way down and you can say, where can I get it? And you just click there to download it and install it in your PowerPoint. I'm going to show you what it looks like over here on mine. Let's just create a new document. As soon as you install this add-in, already right here on the file menu, right here in the open menu, you're going to see this new little tab that says social media. So instead of a new PowerPoint file like this, I'm going to go to social media and it's going to give me this new pane of all the different social media platforms that I could possibly be designing thumbnails for or images for, even videos. Of course, we know how to create videos with PowerPoint. So you can do that in for TikTok size, YouTube size, all that other stuff. I'm going to say let's create one for LinkedIn. And right here, you can see there's lots of different canvas sizes for the different social media platforms. So you might have a profile banner, you might have a profile bubble, you might have a post, you might have a reel for Instagram, something like that. So this drop-down menu will give you all the different kinds of sizes that you might need for each of those social media platforms. For LinkedIn here, I'm going to say that we just need, I don't want a profile photo. I'm going to try to do a vertical post here like this. So it's going to be like this. I'm going to create new file once you select the size that you want. When you select that new file, the new file is going to pop up and the sizing has already been done for you. The slide is no longer 16 by 9, that widescreen orientation that we get by default. It's now this vertical post for LinkedIn, perfect for my LinkedIn wall right there. You can see that it also gives you just this little square that says, once you've finished your design, click File, Social Media, and Save as Picture. I love that they gave us this little instruction. When you're finished with this, you can just go ahead and get rid of it. I'm just gonna show you one that I kind of made over here. Let's look at this one. I made these ones for my LinkedIn post. This one got a lot of views over on LinkedIn. Go check it out, Making a Copy, How to Make a Copy of Your Google Doc. Super easy little pro tip there. But I just love being able to do this in the click of a button. This was such a handy thing. Now, you don't have to just create a new social media file from that menu right here. What if you already had some thumbnails like I do? And let's go back to my file here. So I have my big thumbnail file. And what if I just wanted to transfer everything into the sizing? Now, it's still going to make us do a little bit of design work on the end, but you can do this in one quick swoop. If you already had a 16 by 9 orientation right here, just go back up to that design tab. You're also now going to see that you have this social media button, this social media drop-down menu under the customize menu. And so once you download that add-in, you will have this social media icon right there too. And you're just going to go ahead and say, I want to go back to LinkedIn and I want to make everything a, let's do a vertical post just because I think it's going to be really different. It's going to look really different for us. So I'm going to go ahead and click this and then we will see what happens. It transitioned everything. So everything was proportional to my widescreen 16 by 9. You can see I'm still going to have to work with some of this stuff. I'm going to click into one of my slides. So you can see all the design elements kind of stay like that. But now all I have to do is for each of my elements, I'm just going to have to kind of redo some redesigning. And I would want to do that anyway for, for the platform or for the dimensions that I would sort of be doing. So all of my little design elements there, I can go ahead and just resize. I can work through that as I wish. But you can see all of my slides have been changed and all the design elements will just have to be sort of worked on a little bit to nudge into place and things like that. So I hope that you go back to Bright Carbon. We're going to go plug their site one more time. Go to their page right here. I'm going to link again above and below. Go there, download this free PowerPoint add-in. Thank you so much, Jamie, for your brilliance in giving this to the PowerPoint community and giving it to us all for free as well. I know a lot of you out there, especially if you haven't made the jump over to Canva or some other design platform, maybe you want to use PowerPoint. It's just easier in your workflow to use for things like website graphics, blog graphics, social media graphics, things like that. We've been doing this for a long time, and now Bright Carbon has made it easier for us to do it. So I hope you go and check that out and download this add-in. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and click the subscribe button. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.